Hello friends, welcome to my pedagogy class, and today's topic is direct method, which is one of the methods in old methods of teaching English. It is also known by the names like natural method, reformed method and mother's method. In this particular method, teacher comes in direct conversation with the students without any use of mother tongue or other mediating language. It originated in France in 1901 and later on popularized by International Phonetic Association in France. It is based on following principles. Modern language like English can be taught directly through conversation, discussion and reading without studying formal grammar or translation. It believes that speaking a language is always by far the shortest road to read and write it. Sentence is the unit of speech. Grammar is taught inductively, that is from known to unknown, from concrete to abstract. There should not be any use of mother tongue. It is strictly prohibited. And it believes that self-expression increases if the gap between active vocabulary and passive vocabulary decreases. Here you need to understand that active vocabulary comes when a student is in direct conversation with teacher in English. While when we use mother tongue as mediating language, then the words you hear in English, they come to your passive vocabulary. So in previous video also I have discussed that mother tongue is a kind of barrier. There are some techniques that are to be followed in this method, and they are: there is direct and constant conversation all the time in English. Translation or use of mother tongue is strictly prohibited. Instead, teacher provides student where students need help or they stammer or they stumble. Teacher also enables student to understand the concept through audiovisual aids, pictures, graphs, flashcards, cue cards, facial gestures, and even sometime acting. Now let's discuss its merits and demerits. First, merits. It uses various techniques like audiovisual aids, pictures, graphics, flashcards, cue cards, etc. This already we have discussed. And it is expected from a teacher to use all these kinds of teaching learning materials. Second, it discourages cramming. Third, it increases active vocabulary. This already we have discussed in previous part. It improves fluency and command over language. And finally, there is direct experience between words and experience, which removes the barrier of mother tongue. Now let's discuss its demerits. It has following demerits. It is expensive due to extensive use of audiovisual aids and teaching learning material. It ignores reading and writing aspect. Third, abstract terms like truth, honesty, justice, etc. cannot be showed through flashcards, cue cards, audiovisual aids, etc. They are difficult to explain through this method. Fourth, it demands a skillful teacher. That means teacher has to be fluent, active and creative. And the last one, it is not profitable in linguistically diversified country like India. For example, a child who comes from Garhwali background, he strives to learn Hindi and then he immediately comes to learn English, and so it becomes difficult for him. So learners, we have discussed merits, demerits and techniques used in direct method. This is all about direct method. Thank you for watching this video.